The Muskie season bites straight through the season here has been fantastic. Opening weekend, there's probably 100 fish caught offshore. Definitely an excellent season for muskies. Ever since the opening till now, it's not uncommon to get a guy catching 2-3 fish a night. Most popular bait down here this year was the eat me lure.
What about live bait? You mentioned something that people usually wipe you out of suckers. That's working pretty good too?
Suckers are extremely popular for not only the muskies, but also for, there were some pretty large flathead catfish caught. In the warmer months here, and guys were using 10 and 12 inch suckers for that. The flatheads definitely preferred live bait over anything. Two of them were actually caught incidental to muskie fishing. And later on, as in the fall, as we progressed here, I mean, there's been some large slot walleyes, 24 to 29 inch stuff, all caught on 10 to 12 inch sucker.
Yeah. so we'll show some pictures about that. And then what about different crankbaits? What was popular this season?
They sold quite a few, the Death Raider, the Death Raider,
about the YouTube video so people can find it. And where is this gentleman from?
This gentleman, he's from Evansville, Wisconsin. We're definitely promoters of local tackle builders.
This is awesome.
We're local guys, we want to take care of the local people.
So the development in this one, now they added this ring, because this is the original one, right? The one that carried on the
side, you work in a circle, you would adjust the tail to make the circle bigger, smaller. But now if you set it top of hook up, you would hook it there and it would work in a Z for trolling. Hooking it on the side was just, it was too hard to couldn't work slow enough to make it work better.
So you had a great first season. See, the shelves are almost cleaned out. You need to restart for next year. Who is your clientele for the most part? Wisconsin people, who else?
Well, I would definitely say probably 75% of my clientele is from out of town. Definitely a lot of Polish, Ukrainian, Russian people here. This was the first time that I ever had to issue some fishing licenses with guys that didn't speak any English and then give me passports written in Polish, and I had to decipher it. But it all worked out, everybody's pretty good.
That's pretty cool. And I love the restoration project you're maintaining with the walleye tournament and the muskie tournament that you had. What happened to the muskie tournament? All the money goes to starting muskie, right?
Right, we had 9 boats that had prepaid. It was a setup to be an 18 boat maximum. 9 boats are prepaid. The floodgates were open.